Welcome to a second example of linear regression. The goals of the video are to perform linear regression on the TI84 graphing calculator, determine how well the line of best fit represents the data, and then make predictions using the regression equation. So for this problem, we have data comparing the year to the percent of births outside of marriage in the United States. The first step in data analysis is to create a scatter plot of the data, but normally when the X volumes are years, they set the first year as the base year, meaning 1970 is when X is equal to 0. So if this is 0, 1975 would be 5, 1980 would be 10, and so on, all the way down to 35. So the first point that we'll plot will be 0, 10.7. The second point will be 5, 14.3, and so on. Notice how I've already labeled the x-axis the years since 1970, and label the y-axis percent of births for the percent of births outside of marriage. Now we'll go ahead and plot these points and see what type of function would best fit the data. And you can see from these green points, a linear model is going to be appropriate for this data. Let's go ahead and duplicate this scatter plot on the graphing calculator, and then we'll determine the line of best fit. So we're going to press STAT, Enter, clear out all of the old data by going to the top of the column, clear, Enter, top of column 1, clear, Enter. So L1 will be the X values and L2 will be the Y values. Now that we have all of the data, we'll adjust the window and then plot the points using the scatter plot feature. So for our window, we're going to change the Y min and Y max so that it will show the values from 0 to 35. I'm going to go and use from negative 5 to 40. I'll go ahead and scale it by 5s. Now for the Y axis, the values must go from 10.7 to 36.8. So let's start at 5 and go up to 40. And we'll scale it by 5s. Now let's go ahead and make sure our stat plot is on. We're going to press second, Y equals. We can see here that it's already on, but if it wasn't, we'd press Enter, highlight on, and then press Enter again. Notice we have the scatter plot selected and L1 and L2 for X and Y. Let's go ahead and press graph. Notice how this scatter plot looks just like the one we did by hand, but also notice there's this line in the screen. And that's because I have an old equation in Y1. So let's go ahead and press Y equals and clear this old equation out. And now we'll press graph again. Now we want to perform linear regression. Before we do that, we want to make sure that we have the diagnostic feature turned on. We want to make sure the calculator gives us R and R squared, or the correlation coefficient and the coefficient of determination. To make sure that it's turned on, we can press second, 0 for the catalog. Scroll down to D for diagnostics. Select diagnostic on, press enter and enter again. And now the calculator will give us R and R squared to help us determine if the model is a good fit. Now we'll perform linear regression by pressing STAT, right arrow once, option 4 for linear regression. But now we also want to store this equation in Y1 automatically. So before we press enter, we're going to press the vars key, right arrow once, enter, select Y1 by pressing enter, and now we'll press enter again, and this will run the linear regression and store the equation in Y1. So here's our equation. The slope is approximately 0.77, and the y-intercept is approximately 10.9. R is approximately 0.99, and R squared is approximately 0.98. Both are very close to 1, and therefore we have an excellent model for the given data. We have a strong positive correlation, and over 98% of the variation of the data can be explained by this linear equation. If we press graph, we can see the line graphed on top of the scatter plot, and we see that line is a very good model for this data. Let's go ahead and write down this equation and then answer some questions. So the first question, is this a good fit for the data? And the answer is yes, since we have a correlation coefficient that's approximately equal to 0.99 and a coefficient of determination, or R squared, is approximately 0.98. So this is an excellent model for our data. Now for the rest of these questions, we're going to go ahead and use the entire regression equation given by the calculator, not the rounded value for the slope and the y-intercept. Number two, if the current trend continues, what percent of babies will be born outside of marriage in 2015? Well, the year represents an x value, but remember that x is the number of years after 1970. So to determine the value of x for our equation, we'll have to take the given year and subtract our base year of 1970. So our x value is going to be 45. We want to know what the y value would be when x is equal to 45. Let's go back to our calculator. We're going to press the second window. We're going to have our table start at 0. We'll have the change in the table be 1. And we'll leave it on automatic. So now if we press second graph, we can scroll down to the x value of 45, and it'll tell us what the corresponding y value would be. So when x is equal to 45, or in the year 2015, according to this model, 45.7% of the births will be outside of marriage. Number three, when will the percent of babies being born outside of marriage reach 50%? Well, if we go back to the calculator, and now we want to determine what x value would produce a y value of 50%. So we'll scroll down further until we see the y value equal to 50%. So it doesn't quite reach it when x is 50, but when x is 51, it does reach over 50%. So x equals 51 represents the year where 50% of the births are outside of marriage. So the base year is 1970 plus 51. So again, based upon our model, in 2021, 50% of the births in the US will be outside of marriage. Number four, what is the meaning of the slope of the best fit line? Well, the slope is the coefficient of x. So our slope is 0.77. Let's go ahead and write this as a ratio. So over 1. The reason that's helpful is this tells us the change in y over the change of x. Well, y represents the percent of births, and x represents the year. So this tells us there's a 0.77% increase of births outside of marriage when x changes by 1, which means per year. And the last question, what is the meaning of the y-intercept of the best fit line? Well, the y-intercept would be the point 0, 10.9. Well, x is 0 represents the year 1970, or our base year. And 10.9 would represent the percent of births outside of marriage. So in 1970, according to the model, 10.9% of births were outside of marriage. And we actually had this data from the table. The data told us that it was only 10.7%. So what we're noticing here is that there is a margin of error with our model, and that's just showing that with any model, there's going to be limitations. I hope you found this example helpful. Thank you for watching.